Hello, Celestial, an interesting project right now. Now keep in mind, this is barely on Kickstarter. It might have a lot of progress on the game itself, and this is the free version of the game, meaning the prologue only. But the game will probably be very slow to complete, so I don't recommend you support any game in Kickstarter, because I'm a firm believer of you should be able to play the game you're playing for unless you really have some money, you know, for free. Give someone money for free. It's kind of like a tough year, and besides, the last 2 years have been kind of rough as well, so I just hope everyone gets to play the games they have paid for, play the full games they have paid for, so, well, maybe if some friends of mine make a game, I might support them, but even so, I think Kickstarter is very, very risky. I don't even support early access anymore that much, so let's dive right in. Again, in my opinion, there is no huge... How should I put it? There will be no huge surprises in terms of gameplay or game in general. So, I don't think we'll ever find a game that will surprise us so much that will say, hey, this is amazing, I want to help the developers. They'll just be banking on your wish to get a great game. And, you know, usually people are disappointed by this. So that's why I don't really believe in hype trains anymore. I don't really believe in great games anymore. I just believe... I don't know, you might get entertaining games, you might get interesting games, but overall... The best games that will release next year are continuations or sequels or remasters or reimagining of the same games we had last year's. So, yeah, it's a bit of a downward spiral in my opinion. Yeah, so again, take everything you see over here with a grain of salt. It's made by two people from what I know and what I have read. Yes, they've worked on other major games and they're very experienced and talented, but... I hope everyone gets to... play the games they have paid for. That's kind of like my view on the topic. You know what, I don't really care about what they said over there, I just want to play. The mouse button. Okay, can I... Well, I cannot change my controls, I just hate it. Why do developers have to be so much... Hey, calm down. Why is middle mouse button a thing? It's the most annoying button ever and you cannot... I'm calm. Okay, let's continue. I like his shield. We got the hat? So, pressing F will drop the item. How do I equip the item then? I guess we are already equipping it, or I don't know. So, stamina is over there, or mana is over there, that's our health, that's the keys, okay. Okay, we have to go the other way. I looked over there, but just checking to make sure. Yeah, I mean, if this was the full version of the game, I'd be happy to play all of it. Well, it's a bit exaggerated on the special effects side. Yeah, I can already see a problem. This is mostly made for a console and not PC because the way the controls are handled are very easy. Yeah, I kind of understand what they're going for. So it's unequipped. So they're going for more of that controller snappiness where you fight. The fight seemed very, very fast and very special or dramatic, but what I'm doing is just pressing left click. And people are, and I mean, whatever those things are dying all around me. Okay. I have 11 coins so far. So I have an upgrade. Precise katana heavy attack. Oh, so the upgrades are only available for a few swords. Oh, that's nice. Yeah, that is actually a real-life technique when you shoot the katana and make a mighty slash like that. Let's look at our controls again. So, move, shift is block, use relic, open inventory, interact, heavy attack, use sword, sorry. Yeah, doesn't look like the game really wants you to parry that much anyway. You just have to click and hold. Okay. Ouch. Sharpness up. I'm not sure what that is. Okay, the heavy attack will get me killed. Okay, let's go. Oh, I have to kill this one as well. That's a pretty devastating special if you ask me. Okay, now we're actually entering the realm of jokes, memes and stuff like that. Now, the only reason I'm playing this game is because I thought it was an interesting project and also saw another YouTuber played, but the way he played it was pretty easy. He just made a kind of like a little review on the game itself and said this is very promising, and now that I see it myself, I'm not sure if it's so promising. Yeah, this would be great on Nintendo Switch or older versions of the consoles, but I think we are a little beyond this point in game development. Also, well, you know me, I think I like children's game more than I like adults game, or at least the ones that are rated, you know, R or stuff like that. But this doesn't really strike a balance with me. More health. Yeah, don't fall into the spike pits. You can run, but you cannot hide. Oh, what? You cannot discharge your katana if there is... Well, that's a weird rule. You cannot use your katana if you're so close to this, like... It worked that time. Okay, so that, I guess that's the max range it can go. So we can do kind of like a heavy attack, but with less charged. See, I'm stuck over here. I don't know why he's not using the heavy attack. I was pressing right click. Hey, you know, running. No, I think they should have just sticked with the right weapons. I mean, even though these are pretty fantasy and annoying, at least they look like they deal damage. Come on, double scissors. That makes you just look tiny. I feel like I'm playing Grounded right now. Maybe I should play that game. Maybe it has enough content now. Okay, so looks like this would be kind of like a game based on repetition, quick restart. I'm not sure how we will heal, he didn't say that. more content and refinement for the final game. I'm not sure I like this because, like I said, it's not really up to the standards of modern gaming. I mean, you don't really have a lot of games like this nowadays, but I can kind of see why. If you want to play something similar, well, I guess we'll just have to... I have no idea. I didn't really play a lot of games like this. The only one I remember is Silver, but that game is amazing. And, well, it might be 20-something years old, but it's still better than this, in my opinion. Hammering the metal. Wow, it takes a very long time to reload after you die. I mean, to load the game again, or probably we'll start from zero. I'm not sure I really like what I see. The paper cutana. Yeah, I only died because I didn't understand how the heavy attack works. Oh, so it works the same for all of them. I was pressing middle mouse, but oh, that's what it does, it launches a paper airplane. I'm not sure they really thought of this very well, so it apparently, depending on your RNG, you might get super hard arenas or you might get super easy ones, and depending on your sword, you might have a super easy time or a super hard time. I mean, if you compare the katana special sword series, I mean, you just dash around the entire map and cut stuff and do a lot of damage in the end, this one just sends a paper airplane flying towards your enemies, which is not really efficient. Well, to be honest, I think it's time for me to kind of play some games I don't really like to give my opinion on, and this probably will be one of them. Because so far I have been playing 90% games that I liked, or at least had some potential to them, I mean... I think I skipped about 100 games in the last months, even though we didn't have a lot of releases, I still kept up with the games and decided not to play them. Hey, what if you don't like two-handed swords? I mean, two dual swords, whatever you want to call them. No, nobody really uses them in history, dual wielding. It's a fantasy thing and I learned to accept it as it is. And this is supposed to be my parry, so the parry is also dependent on your weapon. Okay, let's try to get the better sword. Oh. He fell into the pit. Okay, I can already tell you this is super clunky compared to the other ones. They also seem to take a lot of damage. I mean, not a lot of damage. I need a lot of stamina to execute the combos to kill them. Maybe I should lock onto them. What was the lock on button? That's one way to kill them. Yeah, the game is beautiful overall, but it's still clunky and the individual quality of the swords or the weapons is vastly different. I'm out of stamina, so that's why I cannot attack anymore, or not as fast as I want. So I barely do any damage with this one. What? I'm pressing the middle mouse button to activate the special. But I was not getting anything. Yeah, you died. Let's have another quick restart. I thought this was going to be a more of a roguelike experience, but it seems like the prologue at least is more like try until you succeed type of deal. Yeah, after playing The Last Stand Aftermath, I kind of had to raise my bar for arcade games or games like this or roguelikes in general. That game has so many good elements in it, I mean, I still get angry at some of the things it does, but overall, yeah, that definitely raised the bar for me regarding this type of games. Okay, let's try it. Let's give it another try or two. But as you saw, with a katana, with no effort, I basically destroyed everything and I only took damage because I was trying to understand the mechanic. Really, again with the silly swords and harder arenas. They simply refuse to fall into the pit. Dodge. No, I think I'll just want the katana attack, even though I don't have the katana with me. Yeah, this game will be a nightmare to balance. I mean, it's no Hades. Oh, this is so annoying. I died again. Okay. Can I get the real sword? The two-handed dual blades are so stupid. And I guess that's my opinion of the game so far. I don't really think it will be worth it, but I guess we can expect a lot of good things from the full release. Maybe I'll try it then if it has more interesting elements, but so far the basic gameplay premise is kind of bad in my opinion. You're going to get different quality swords in the beginning, and you're going to fight RNG arenas with more or less dangers or more or less stronger enemies, so it's going to be one hammering the metal. It's going to be one that will be mostly up to the people themselves, if this is their type of game they prefer. It's not going to be one of those short sword. One of those games that appeals to a lot of gamers. Even though you don't like the genre. For example, there are Billions or other games that basically made everyone like them, or most people. Somehow I'm killing them in one or two hits. Ruggles. What other games appeal to a very big amount? Well, I guess Among Us and Valheim and some other games. Even though I... Well... Yeah, this is so much better than the Dual Swords. Well, I guess that's a problem because I'm not looking onto the enemies. Oh, I like this one a lot, yeah. I guess it's hit or miss because there are many banking on memes, jokes and other things which I don't really appreciate in game, come on. I can appreciate humor and some other stuff in video games, but don't make your main gameplay mechanics humor or memes. Yeah, this is 10 times better. But I had that coming. Oh, so they can launch there. Okay, interesting. Vampiric finish. I guess this is what I needed. Let's go into the big room. Ah. Okay, so I have 47 HP. 49, so I get 2 HP per defeated enemy. health up. Okay, so that's the... Oh, healing item. And yours, your character also looks always in the direction where your mouse is pointing. Huh, such a quick finish. I don't know what that is. Looks like the special weapon ability is a parry. I'm not sure how I use the charge, but again, this is mostly about the gameplay. Yeah, you're also stuck in animations. If you start them, you cannot change the animations. So what is the button to... Cycle locked on enemy, but it doesn't... How do you... Oh. Well, with E, I guess you just use the trap, but I'm not sure how you lock onto the enemy. Yeah, the movement is pretty clunky as well. This reminds me of a combo from Devil May Cry, where you just... push the enemies into the air and then attack them. So... I can set a trap again, apparently. Wait, how did I... Oh. With R. Wait, why does this little guy take so little damage? Because I'm out of stamina. Okay, so stamina is definitely one of the things that limits you. Maybe too much. They still take reduced damage. Why? Maybe this is one of those challenge rooms. Well, follow me. Oh, okay. Okay, this is annoying. Looks like the main mechanic will be, of course, locking onto your enemies and then attacking them, because you don't move in any direction when you attack. You seem to be stuck in place, depending on your weapon. Not a big fan of the stamina system either. Oh, your weapons break, so you're forced to use other ones. Wow, that's a silly mechanic in my opinion, really? I looked at the weapon itself and it said it had a big X on it, so that means your weapons break. So what's the point of choosing upgrades for a weapon that might break? I don't know. I mean, this is what happens when you have talent and, you know, you like to make games. You just make a great game and then you give it some weird mechanics that you think people will like. For example, weapons breaking, yeah. People love that mechanic, or, you know, crawling into dark caves for hours. Sure, people love to look at the same walls. Okay, let's give it another go and then I'll end the video. I wasn't expecting this to be such a... I mean, it's not necessarily a negative review. Like I said, this is a game meant for people who love the genre, but not for other people who might want to test it or play it. This is not going to be like The Binding of Isaac or either similar games. Falcon. I guess that's a Falcon Slash instead of a Falcon Punch. Yeah, the quality of the swords varies vast, I mean... The game will basically make you play with inferior swords. There is no escape. So unless you are getting that perk that will heal you every time you kill an enemy or that healing item, you're not going to heal HP. Okay, let's play a few more minutes. I mean, it's enjoyable to some degree. And yeah, sometimes you just get comboed, you run out of stamina. I guess the main trick over here is to not get all of the enemies to attack you. But on the other hand, if you don't have a way to heal it... Sharpness up, okay, yes, that's how you heal your sword. You get stuck so easy on something. Yeah, looks like some... okay, I understand. Yeah, I can't remember the name of that other game that had similar mechanics, but there you had also skills, you had perks, you had different weapons. You also had the game where you fall asleep and then you go into the game itself, and in the real world you just have to interact with people. Make friends, give them gifts. What is still alive? Okay, I like this one more. What's this? Phew. Fires a beam. Okay, that's nice. That's nice. Well, I guess, in a way, I didn't want to prove a point or anything, but I guess my idea stands... yeah, early access games and a lot of indie studios are kind of promising projects and nothing more than that. Kickstarter games, early access, new indie dev studios which making interesting concepts and great artwork and stuff like that, but overall... just might be a great concept or great on paper. What? I finished the map? Now I have to go back? Okay, let's teleport over there. Let's see what's in this small room. It was only a chest. Thank you, but no thank you, bye. you can take your weapon into ground and I don't want to play with it. I guess I've seen all I wanted to see. Not really happy with the way the game is played, or at least this part of this prologue at least. Well, that's something different, alright. Again, the prologue is for free, probably to get updates when the full game is released, or maybe even more, but as means this is version 1.02. Pretty basic for what it's supposed to be. Yeah, probably the full release will be a lot better, but for now I think it's an interesting project that might deserve a little bit of attention, but overall it's not really what I was, it's not the quality that I was expecting. A prologue is different from a demo. A prologue should be a fully polished thing. A demo could be unpolished or stuff like that, but I don't know. Prologue is, imagine the prologue from Stone Shard and compare it to this prologue. Yeah, it's miles in quality. Anyway, it's for free. What can you lose if you play it? Bye.